Hello children, good morning. Let us start with our chapter 10, 3 sacks of rice, page number 23. Now rice, you all know the thing which we eat, yes? And sacks means a bag in which rice has been kept. You may have read many stories about three brothers. Usually, two of them, the elder ones, are strong, clever but unkind. Now you must you may be remembering your fourth standard chapter, that is that three brothers, Gluck, Hans. Yes, you remember? So in that, the third one was very kind, but the two of them were very unkind and evil, right? But they laugh at the youngest one because he is too simple and soft-hearted. So they always used to laugh at the youngest one, who is the smallest. Our story also has three brothers who lived in a small town, but they were all three of them honest, kind and hardworking. Now here we have a story wherein the three brothers are honest, kind and hardworking. All are honest, kind, hardworking. The elder one ran a shop. Now what did the elder one do? He was running a shop. The middle one was a priest. The middle one was a priest. Priest means the person who takes care of the temple. And the youngest one who just finished his education. So the youngest one was very young and he just finished his education. He had started taking up odd jobs to earn some money and to learn trade. So he started doing some small jobs to get money. Yes, and he also started to learn trade, buying and selling. All three of them were fond of their mother. She had worked hard to bring up the three of them after the sudden death of their father. So mother worked very hard. Yes, she gave them all the necessary things. Why? Because of the sudden death of their father. So father couldn't take care of the children. That is why mother did all the work. One day, their father's friend visited the mother. He said, "Sister, you know that I have a very prosperous business." See here, she is the mother. And father's friend, he is coming and saying that he is having a prosperous business, successful business. "But now, I am getting old and my only daughter is of marriageable age." So what is the man saying? That he is getting old and his daughter is of marriageable age. Marriageable age means about to get married. "I am looking for a son-in-law who would be a good husband to my daughter and who would also handle my business well." So he is saying, "I want one son-in-law who would be a good husband to his daughter." So uski beti ko acha पति रहना चाहिए. "And who would also handle my business well, and he should also take care of his business. I like all your sons." Now this lady had how many sons? Correct, three sons. So he said, "I like all your sons. If you allow, I will marry my daughter to one of them, but before that I have a plan." So he's saying, "If you allow me, then I'll tell my daughter to marry one of your sons. But before that, I have a plan." He discussed the plan with her and she agreed quite readily. So he told his plan to the mother and she said, "Okay, you can go ahead." The next day, the friend went to each of the three brothers one by one. So the next day, this friend, he went to the brothers one by one. He gave them each a sack of rice and said, "My dear boy, I am going away for a few months for some necessary work." This uncle, this, what is he? He is a father of that daughter, right? So that friend, he came to each of the brother and he gave one sack of rice. And what did he say? That he wants to go out. "Please look after this sack of rice till I come back." So what is he saying? "Please take care of this sack of rice till I came back." The friend went away. Many months passed, but he did not return. Now what happened? He told that he'll be coming back by some months, but he did not come back. It was nearly a year before he came back. So it was nearly a year. He visited the eldest brother first. So first he came and he visited the eldest one. Eldest, sabse bada, oldest. The eldest brother welcomed him and gave him a small purse full of money. So what did the eldest brother do? He welcomed him. He said, welcome. And he gave him a small purse full of money. Uncle, you had left a sack of rice with me. After a few months, I was worried that it may get spoilt. Therefore, I sold the rice to my customers. Here's the money I got. Please accept it. What did the eldest brother say? That it was very... he waited for some months. But after some months, he thought that the rice will get spoiled, damaged. So what did he do? He sold it to his customers. Right? And that is why he got some money and he gave it. Why customers? Correct. Because he ran a shop. Right? The first one ran a shop. He had a shop. Thank you, my boy. You are such an honest person. So, since this eldest one gave this friend some money, so he said, wow, thank you. You are very honest.